Dear Facebook Pure Urology viewers, good evening one and all. As you all know that every alternate day we are conducting talks with seniors who have experience in surgical technique, predominantly video based. As you all know that the urethroplasty surgery has changed.
Dear Facebook Pure Urology viewers, good evening one and all. As you all know that every alternate day we are conducting talks with
so we actually are doing today urethroplasty. As you all know, the urethroplasty has changed the management a lot in the last three decades. Usually in our talks we see surgeons who does surgery very well, but today is a special day where one surgeon has invented the procedure. The moderator has changed it on his own name and made it his own technique. These are the two pioneers, Dr. Guido Barbagli sir and Dr. Sanjay Kulkarni sir. When I was going through the history way back in 1996, when I was in MBBS itself, the buccal mucosa was thought of, buccal mucosa was kept, and now we are practicing entire world the same buccal mucosa. This is the era of buccal mucosa. Still in the near future we don't know the replacement for urethra. Before that, Guido Barbagli sir has already gone into the stem cell research, taking the buccal mucosal cell and now published mucocell recently, so that you need not wait for a long buccal mucosa to regrow in a secondary or tertiary, second time or third time cases. Similarly, after Barbagli sir has developed this buccal mucosa graft, preferably dorsal on leg graft in the initial days, over a period of time we have seen, particularly Indians and of course now the entire world has seen, how Dr. Sanjay Kulkarni sir has shown his technique of no need of mobilization of the entire urethra 360 degrees. If you are keeping the buccal mucosa, you can still cut the lateral part of the urethra, put graft on the fixed part, then again close it in the other part, so that it will give the same result. This is the one technique he has innovated. And second one is the urethra is invaginated. We all used to cut the penile skin, we all used to cut the urethral skin. Even I remember in my PG days 15 years back that perineal incision and urethral incision were different. Edema was more and the post-operative pain was more, but Kulkarni sir has shown his technique where entire urethra up to the meatus can be invaginated into the perineum, buccal mucosa can be kept. Both of these speakers are precious for me in Pure Urology. This will be a memorable day because Barbagli sir has invented the buccal mucosa and Kulkarni sir has made his own technique. With this introduction, I want to ask few questions, both of them, to encourage the juniors about their career. Barbagli sir, can you unmute both of you, sir?
Can I introduce one minute?
Sir, I wanted to ask a few questions about your career.
Yes, no problem.
When did you develop interest in your surgical career about urethroplasty?
1978.
Who was your mentor?
George Webster.
In which place? Italy?
Duke University, America.
That time, what was the common mode of treatment of urethroplasty?
What
what was the main treatment of urethral stricture?
At this time, we perform many two-stage urethroplasty, After we develop 1996, one stage, and after, in the same period, we start introducing oral mucosa. So, but the development of our technique happened at the end of 90 years, And in 2000, we started with a new progression in uretral surgery. At the beginning, it was no elegant, was rudimental uretral surgery at the beginning of our experience. But after, step by step, of course, some innovation like oral mucosa or like ASOPA technique or like my dorsal OLE technique are improved the quality of surgery, the no complication rate. So this step represent very, very important innovation in uretral surgery, important innovation.
Yes, sir. What are the other tissues you thought of to replace the buccal mucosa at that time? What are
rarely. We now at present in anterior urethral stricture disease, penile or barbar, we use oral mucosa about in 90% of cases. Of course, we rarely we use the skin flap, never, or occasionally 1, 2, 3 cases in year, and rarely we use the prepuzial skin for grafting. For few reasons, because oral mucosa is fantastic material for urethroplasty because it's elastic, resilient, don't fold for diverticulum formation. Is the scar harvesting is in the mouth, patient don't see the scar. They are many advantages. Is abundant because you can take left and the right cheek. So all these factors render the oral mucosa the ideal material for urethroplasty. No discussion about this. No discussion.
Yes, sir. Sanjay Kulkarni, sir. When did you get interaction with Gudo Barbagli, sir, in your career? How you became together and worked on the urethroplasty to the research level?
Yeah. So I was trained by Richard Turner Warwick in 1986 in England, and I met Guido Barbagli in London, where there was a course arranged by Professor Tony Mundy. George Wester was there, and I met Guido in 1997 for the first time, and I brought the Barbagli technique to India and introduced it to the Indian urologists. So Guido has been my mentor, and then we worked together. Subsequently, I visited his center. He came down to Pune many times, and the collaboration continues.
Sir, you have done laparoscopic surgery very nicely. You have done general urology nicely. I don't know about your PCNL surgical skills, but when you had taken complete U-turn to urethroplasty, which year that made entire change and made your own name?
So after I met Guido, then he asked me, Sanjay, what is your interest? And I said, urethroplasty and laparoscopic surgery. He said, forget about laparoscopy, concentrate on urethroplasty. And that changed my career completely. So it was not easy for me to give up something where I was
good
at. Yeah, but I listened to him, and that has changed. So today we did 5 urethroplasties in one day, and this is our routine now. So Guido told me at that time that there will be day when you have no time to do anything else, only urethroplasties, and
great.
That's coming out true.
Great. I really appreciated both of you.
I just want to show you one fact of life. This is what Guido described his technique. His technique changed the way we perform urethroplasty. He used to show his hand like this, a complete U-turn. And then that has changed the way urethroplasty is performed around the world. So Guido is very instrumental in changing the method of treatment. Yeah.
Great, sir. Great. Highly appreciated. I like to introduce both of you on this important day in Pure program. Today talk is dorsal onlay buccal mucosal graft urethroplasty. The speaker is Dr. Guido Barbagli, and he is the director of the Center for Reconstructive Urethral Surgery, which he founded in 1999 in Arezzo, Italy. Currently, he holds a position as a limited term professor for the Postgraduate School of Urology at the Department of Medicine and Surgery, University Vita Salute San Raffaele Milan, Italy. He is a member of the following scientific societies: SIU, AUA, EAU, SIU and SIA. He acts as a referee for the most important scientific journals. He has been participant and invited keynote speaker to the numerous national and international meetings and congresses. He has been appointed president of the Society of GURS Genitourinary Reconstructive Surgeons for the period 2008-2009. Scientific articles, 91 publications edited and printed in international scientific journals, and 4 books on reconstructive urethral surgery. As you all know, today moderator Dr. Sanjay Kulkarni sir, he is the from Pune, India. We are all proud of you that you are from India, has reached an international level in this field of urology. Is a consultant urologist in KEM Hospital Pune, is president of Society of International Urology SIU 2019-21, a big applaud for that is such a high post it is. He is past president GURS Urology Society of Pune West Zone Urology USI. He is secretary of International Society of Reconstructive Urology, Urology Gold Medal awarded West Zone, Urology Gold Medal awarded for outstanding contribution by USI in 2011 itself. AUA President Gold Medal also from Indian section he got. Honorary Member British Association of Urology Surgeons in 2018. He is a editorial board journal for Journal of Robotic Surgery, Current Journal of Urology Surgery and many other journals. Chandigarh Best Video in 2016, Best Poster and Best Video in 2006 when he was practicing laparoscopic surgery, which I have seen during my period of MCH. With this, I request the esteemed speaker today, Dr. Gudo Barbagli sir, to take over the program. And thank you once again, both of you, for being with us for this limited period of time. Thank you, sir.
I can start the video?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Sì, parti, però fermalo subito quando c'è il titolo, eh. Okay, let me introduce my today video. The first, I like present the dorsal olei urethroplasty in penile and in bulbar urethra. According to the ASOPA technique in penile with some important modification, and according to my technique, I described it in 1996 for bulbar dorsal olei graft urethroplasty. But listen, before to present the urethroplasty, I like to present our technique we publish a few times in Journal of Urology for harvesting the oral mucosa. Because you know, oral mucosa is the preferred material for urethroplasty, but you need clarify better the technique for harvesting the oral mucosa. Because till now, they are many confusion in literature about harvesting the oral mucosa, closing, not closing, graft, big, and I show you the technique we use, and recently in World Journal of Urology, we present our result in 847, more than 800 patients using this technique. And the instrument now I show you with a very, very high success rate and low complication rate and satisfaction for patients. So it's important for me that people need learn step by step how we harvest the oral mucosa from the cheek. This is fundamental steps. We can start with the harvesting the oral mucosa from the cheek. I start.
Today, we'll show a one-stage penile urethroplasty using oral mucosa graft and glue. The video is divided into two parts. Part one, how to harvest the oral mucosa graft from the cheek.
And
the instrument,
sorry, you can see here the table for instrument to use for oral mucosa harvesting. The first message, when we perform oral mucosa graft, we use two different team. I prepare my urethra and my assistant, Dr. Sofia, arrange the harvesting the oral mucosa. And we start at the same time, because when I open the urethra, I have my mucosa ready in the table. This is important message. Till now, in many hospitals or many people that present urethroplasty don't use this double team technique. It's fantastic. I learned this in San Francisco at the school of Jack Mecken. Now, this is the instrument I show you, the most important instrument we use. And listen what we use. There are many, many mouth retractors, but we start many years ago using this fantastic retractor here. This is the Kilner Daugherty retractor, mouth retractor. This is the best retractor for the mouth and is available in any oral surgeon department. Start using this and you will be happy. I show you why. It's very easy to use and how you can see here, they are this instrument for the tongue, putting down the tongue, and they are more instrument for the teeth. Now you show, I show you how it's very easy to apply this retractor in the mouth. This is ophthalmic scalpel, another important instrument, not traumatic. This is bipolar coagulator. This is injection of adrenaline and bupivacaine, and this is tablet to clean the oral graft. This is marked pen and the matter. Look how it is easy and is fantastic. Open the mouth with this retractor. You put on the teeth, you put down the tongue, you stretch, and look here. This is the mouth open for the harvesting. Fantastic view. After that, it's better to stretch a little bit the mucosa to render the removal of graft more easier. By simple three stitches, five stitches in the border of the lip. The mucosa is stretched. Look how is fantastic the oral mucosa. After that, you need to identify the Stenson duct below the second molar. And after that, you design the graph you need. On this case, we need no big graph, you can see here. And you start injection of adrenaline and bupivacaine to facilitate the hemostasis and the dissection of the graph. This is another important step. After that, you start removing the graph from the mouth. We use 5-0 for this procedure. We make incision. You can see the ophthalmic scalpel, how it's nice, very precise, very, very nice, very elegant. And we start removing the mucosa. In this step here, I show you now, is important, as you can see here, when you remove the graft, you need to leave the muscle down. Don't remove the muscle. You need to be superficial here. The muscle should be put down. It's important this for closure later. You see that the muscle is put down like this. This technique in the end of my assistant require not more than 10-15 minutes. And my assistant now harvest about 1,000 oral mucosa. And she is able to harvest the mucosa in any condition, in any patient. It's important having one assistant specialized on this. After that, we make bipolar coagulation of some vessel, and we start closing the oral mucosa. The closure of oral mucosa graft is fundamental. Apart if you harvest rectangular big graft for two-stage urethroplasty, on this case, you can close. You need open, leave open it. but the closure render the post-operative course without acute, as you can see here. And after you remove, you clean the graft. The graft is ready for implant. I am ready with the urethra and the graft ready in my table. Now, this is penile urethra stricture disease in the middle part of the penis. And in this case, we prefer direct approach, not circumcision or more aggressive surgery. A simple longitudinal incision near the stricture, you can see where the catheter stops here. We make incision over the tip of the catheter, like you can see here, with the scalpel, we incise over the tip of the catheter and we progress to expose the stricture disease. I show you now. This is very easy surgery. Don't require particular training or learning curve. The advantage of using the ASOPA, the mucosa, is that it's easy. Any people can perform this surgery without special training or important follow the steps I show you now. You see, it's better before progress to insert small catheter anytime, because the risk is lose the lumen here and they destroy the lumen. Any urethra when open is better to insert the small catheter to follow him. Now we open more the urethra, of course. Another important steps. Look here. You need to open the urethra not only at the stricture part here, but 2 centimeters more distally and 2 centimeters more proximally, because this is the urethra involved in the disease. But you need to make enlargement also on this normal part here, but is not normal also this part and this part here, because you need to consider that the 2 centimeter urethra stricture disease really is 5 centimeter stricture disease, not only 2 centimeter here. After that, we make, look the urethral plate and look the stricture disease. Start here and start finish here. Now we make snodgrass incision of the urethral plate on the midline. This is the marked part of the stricture disease. You see, using the same scalpel, we make a big incision of the urethral plate, of the mucosa only, not spongiosum downstream tissue, the mucosa only. It's important to make this enlargement of the urethra plate, like this. You see here, like this. And you can see my new urethral plate here, how it's large, and the mucosa ready to be implanted. Now, few years ago, we started using glue to fix the mucosa to the urethral plate. Nice glue, very efficient. And you can see the glue is injected in the urethral plate. You see the glue is very efficient glue, this one. And after the glue, you need to press the mucosa for 45 seconds to be efficient. After 45 seconds, you remove the pressure and you can see what happened. The oral mucosa is really exactly extended. The advantage of using the glue is that the oral mucosa is well fixed and well extended in the oral plate, in the urethral plate. You don't need to make a quilted. with many, many stitches here. Because look how it is well distended, the mucosa. And this probably help the outcome. After that, you insert the foley silicone. Not another question is about which catheter using in penile urethroplasty. In penile urethroplasty is mandatory use small catheter, not more than 12 French catheter. You can see we used this silicone grooved catheter. Why we need to put small catheter? Because after urethroplasty, they are secretion in the part you make urethroplasty. And if you put a big catheter, you close the meatus with the catheter and the secretion remain inside in the urethra. If you put small catheter, you allowed to the secretion of the urethra of the muco to come out. This is important suggestion. When you perform urethroplasty, it's not necessary to include 26, 24, 28 catheter. It's not the catheter that make your urethra, it's your surgery. So another important suggestion, small catheter in any penile urethroplasty for 1 month, not minimum. We don't like suprapubic tube. Never, 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 never we insert a suprapubic tube after urethroplasty. Apart if patient come back in the hospital just with suprapubic tube. Because some people say that we need also suprapubic tube for drain the urine. No, the urine are drained by catheter. Suprapubic tube is only a risk. For occlusion, bleeding, no. Urethra surgery should be no aggressive.
Okay.
You see, we insert the catheter inside. And we close directly the spongiosum tissue. It's not important here to do double suture line, mucosa and the spongiosum tissue over. You take the corpus spongiosum and you close, very efficient closure, of course. Because according to some study in the literature, they are the catheter that make the urethra. Because it was published many years ago, an important study from Weaver and Schultz showing that when you open the urethra and you leave a catheter inside, the urethra form over catheter, the urethra form a tube by himself, by himself. So for this reason, it is important to stage urethroplasty. And you see that we published this technique many years ago in British Journal of Urology, and we present 85.7% success rate. Okay, this is the first video. Now I can show you the reconstruction of the reconstruction of bulbar urethra stricture disease by using dorsal Barbagli procedure. The second video, sir. This is a typical, fammi lavorare a me. This is the typical, bulbar.
I don't like scrotal approach.
This is the typical, come faccio a togliere il video, l'audio dal video? Come? Ah, ecco. Va bene? Ok, you see, the first step is dissection of the urethra from the corpora cavernosa. As you can see here, and dissection proceed on this line here is very safe, no problem, because
we are not able to see the video.
Aspetta che non lo vedono. You see now?
No, sir.
Not yet.
Just a minute. Non lo vedono. Just a minute.
Okay, sir, no problem.
It's okay now? It's okay?
No, no, sir, not yet. Maybe
you
close the screen again, restart, it is better.
Allora, chiudi lo screen. Yes, yes, just a minute. Chiudi e ripartiamo, dici.
Dear audience, we will ask the questions at the end once the professor finishes the talk.
Devo fare, scusa. Connetti? No, non ti vedo più. Però vedo, tu mi muovi il mouse. Il mio non funziona, te lo sta muovendo te.
Sir Barbagli, sir, I will stop sharing the screen. You restart with second video.
Yes, yes, yes. One minute, please. We start again.
Yeah.
No, non sto facendo niente.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is okay?
No, this is the old one, sir.
Just a minute.
This is the old one. Yes, sir. Now you share again. audience are there.
Good.
Normally, I don't like to scroll a lot of prayer.
Is okay?
No, we can't see.
You share the screen, sir.
Bisogna dargli lo screen, bisogna dargli condividi. E allora ci entrerò io, dimmi come... Ah, condividi, aspetta, condividi screen, aspetta. Ecco, perfetto. Ora cosa più, c'è il video qui? Sì.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we can see.
You can see? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we can see.
But I don't see in my computer. Ecco, is okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Very clear.
Fallo partire. Okay. You see the bulbar urethra by perineal approach, not scrotal. I never use scrotal approach in my urethroplasty. The scrotum is plenty of vein, bleeding. Come si è fermato? Ah, aspetta. Fallo partire. And we start dissecting the urethra from the corpora cavernosa here. It's very easy steps, this one, because they are a vascular plane from the urethra and the corpora cavernosa. You'd go on opposite side also. And you pass back by curved clamp. Just to stretch a little bit the urethra and progress more distal is possible. You need to consider that 3 centimeters of bulbar urethra require free the urethra for 6-7 centimeters more. You can see here how long is dissection of my urethra. The structure is here, but we start dissecting from here to here because the urethra should be all free here. To access the dorsal part here. And you rotate the urethra to expose. This is the dorsal urethra. Dorsal olei graft is here. Another important suggestion, listen, is to insert a small catheter here in the urethra and to find the lumen, you need the cut on the tip of a catheter. Why the scalpel? You find the tip of a catheter here and it's easy to open the urethra here. Don't destroy the urethral plate here, it's important. Look here, the catheter is here, perfect. And now with this curved sharp, we open the urethra more proximally, you see another important step I like to introduce. No, not now, sorry. Another important steps. We improve many greatly our technique when we start in any bulb urethroplasty, insert small catheter, 3 French, before the surgery. You can realize how it is important these steps. You can realize. We improve the time of our technique. We decrease the risk of destroy anything, introducing this small catheter before the urethroplasty, before open the urethra. Because now I have no problem. I can open all my urethra here following this blue catheter. But if I have not this catheter, I open the urethra here and I lost the lumen here for the fibrosis, for the inflammation, for the urethral mucosa destroyed, you don't find the mucosa here. You don't find with this opening. You need to transect the urethra and find the lumen inside. When you lose the lumen, you don't find him. For this reason, it's important to introduce this before. But why I like to show you this important step? Because till now, when you go in live surgery meeting, you can see also expert urethral surgery that don't use this suggestion. I ask, but why? Oh, but no, it's not necessary because I have no problem, blah, 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 blah. It's not true. It's not true. You have a problem. See this, you lose the urethra, you have a problem. It's not true. It's not true. Oh my God. Also, very expert surgeon, not training student, expert surgeon till now refused to use these fundamental steps. This is fundamental step in urethroplasty. Oh my God. Urethroplasty is plenty of this small suggestion that render the urethroplasty safe, fast, better. You see, we open. Look how it's fantastic. Follow the catheter. It's fantastic. After that, the mucosa is ready in my table. And I can apply the mucosa. Also, in this case, we use glue on the corpora cavernosa. Look here. Many glue on the corpora cavernosa here. And we fix the graft to the glue, pressing for 45 seconds. Look here. This glue is fantastic. It's from Italy company. And after that, as I showed you before, you need to press the mucosa for 45 seconds to the time that the glue is working. But you can realize that this surgery, if you have a double team for harvesting the mucosa, this is 1 hour surgery, not more. It's 1 hour surgery, not 3 hour surgery. Look at the glue, the glue and the graft. After that, the first step is to do mucosa anastomosis from oral mucosa here and urethral mucosa. On this side, on the right side, we do mucosa anastomosis. Look here. The mucosa, urethral mucosa is joined to the urethral, to the oral mucosa here. Only on this side. Only on right side we do mucosa anastomosis. I show you later that in the left side we don't do mucosa, but only spongiosum closure of the urethra. Look here, the urethra fixed on the, just a minute. Look here, the urethra fixed the oral mucosa fixed to the oral mucosa graft, so with this interrupted suture line. Now we put the urethra over the corpus spongiosum here, and we close not here and here, but we close here and here. I show you. In this case, the catheter is 18 catheter. In the bulba urethra, you need the more bigger catheter. Also to make some compression here of the graft. And after you take here, what do we do to close? We take spongiosum tissue, or I show you now better. We take spongiosum tissue here, oral mucosa here, and no, corpora cavernosa here, oral mucosa here, and spongiosum tissue here. It's not important to be meticulous mucosa. It's not important because it's the catheter in place that render the tube, that form the new urethra. Not your stitches, it's the catheter inside. For this reason, we need to leave the catheter 1 month after urethroplasty, because the urethra should be grow around the catheter and require time, require one month. There are some urologists that perform this urethroplasty and they say, no, I make different. I, after 1 week, remove the catheter and leave suprapubic cystostomy. But why? But you don't know the urethra, my friend. You don't know what the urethra is. And what is the process of regeneration of the urethra? You need to study, my friend. You need to study. You need to read the literature about this. And you see, you close. And this technique was greatly modified and Sanjay present and publish many innovation of this dorsal ole technique. Also the nice innovation for panurethra stricture disease. Using the dorsal approach with some important modification. Sanjay is really a big inventor in new technique for urethroplasty. Very, very important technique. No, not only the panurethroplasty, but also this approach. Sanjay is able to modify very intelligent any technique we have now available. His contribution in urethral surgery is fundamental in the last 10 years. Look here, this is my urethra. What is the difference between ventral and dorsal? This is dorsal only. In ventral only is the graft that go on the urethra. In dorsal only is the urethra that go to the graft. This is the main difference. But really, the difference between ventral and dorsal graft is not significant. The success rate in our experience is about the same, 82-83. But of course, the dorsal onlay graft, as I show you here, is suggested for more distal bulbar urethra stricture disease, where the spongiosum tissue is thin and can cover your graft. In the proximal part here, down, we prefer the ventral onlay graft urethroplasty for few reasons. But is don't exist as American people like discuss dorsal or ventral. No, dorsal and ventral. Urethral surgery should be able to do both. In some cases, better ventral, in some cases, better dorsal. Don't exist to compare dorsal or ventral. This is the final. What is the post-operative course? The patient remain with catheter 1 month. 1 month. After that, remove the catheter and at the same time, he perform voiding schistourethrography to check if there are some leakage, some fistula. Listen, some people till now to check the result of ureteroplasty perform double catheter uretrography, leave the catheter inside and perform uretrography inserting a new catheter. Is not useful. You don't see nothing. If you leave a catheter and you perform a uretrography, what do you see? What do you see? Nothing. You need to remove the catheter and ask at patient to void. Is the void in uretrography can show you the result of your ureteroplasty. If they are diverticulum, fistula, formation of irregularity on the lumen, not. What element you had if you have a ducatheter in the urethra and you perform medium contrast? Nothing. You don't see nothing. Till now, you see in the article or some people suggesting double catheter uretrography. I don't know why. I don't know why. It's this simple. It also for patient. Patient come back, you feel the blood there with a catheter, you remove a catheter, you ask him to void, and you say, okay, everything is perfect. The urethra is perfect, no problem. Problem, maybe that in some patient, they are at the first radiological control, a small fistula, small or also maybe sometime a little bit more bigger. What to do? On this case, no problem. You insert again, smaller catheter, smaller than 20, you insert again the urethra 12 French catheter, and you leave this catheter for 1 month more. And after that, you repeat the voiding cysto-uretrography. And you can see that 95% of the fistula are closed, normally, naturally, without any more surgery or without any aggression. 90% or more. After that, maybe that there are one case or two cases that the fistula is better, but not completely closed. No problem. You insert again catheter for 2 weeks more, and you repeat the uretrography. This is my approach. This technique presents 82% of success rate. How any bulba ureteroplasty in the bulba urethra? And this is my final comment. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Guido.
Thank you very much, sir.
Sanjay.
Presentation. Sanjay Kulkarni, sir, there are some questions. And you please guide us how to conduct. Should I ask the questions of the audience first, or you wanted to comment on this?
I wanted to ask him a question.
Yes, sir.
How Guido Barbagli invented this dorsal only technique? There is a story behind a patient who came and wanted one stage. So, Guido, will you tell the story?
How I invented the dorsal?
Yeah.
So, the dorsal was a nice case because one patient came to me who had two stage ureteroplasty, but not in my hand, in other hospital, blah, blah, blah. And he had very, very aggressive, very tired stricture disease in the bulbar part. And I say, but my friend, I can do surgery, but probably we need to do again two stage ureteroplasty on this case because the urethra should be very, very damaged urethra. And he say, no, I don't accept. Or you perform one stage ureteroplasty on the you go out, no problem. Okay, I look again the X-ray and realize that I say, okay, maybe that on this case I can perform end-to-end anastomosis on the bulbar urethra because at the X-ray the io non vedo Kulkarni. Sorry un attimo. Just a minute. At this time, I say, ma In my opinion, we can do end-to-end anastomosis. I start the surgery. What happened? I transect the urethra and the elastic movement. The distal part of the urethra, meow, go out. So, and the proximal part, meow, go down. So I lost 5 centimeters of the urethra. On this case, it was not possible to do end-to-end anastomosis. At time, I see that this patient had the big prepuce. I say, okay, my God, let me check. I take a graph from prepuce, I put on the corpora cavernosa, and I make, improvisely, the first augmented anastomotic repair. This patient, Sanjay, I believe is maybe 20 here, is till now perfect. 22 uroflometry.
Great.
Incredible. But for I don't know why. After that, when I see the results, I start using in few cases at this time and then improve the technique, blah, 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 blah. After George Webster take many, many important suggestions introducing the augmented anastomotic that is a little bit different from my technique, but the contribute of George Webster in dorsal Ulle graph is very important. Is very important.
Thank you, Guido.
Sir,
thank you. Dr. Chandra.
Yes, sir. Sir, how do you decide the breadth of the graft depending on the RGU or on table depending on the spongiofibrosis?
No. In my practice, decision is make evaluating many factors. First one, the site of the stricture, the extension of the stricture, the length of the stricture, of course. But there are also more different problem. The impact of the surgery in patient, the psychological status of the patient, and when it normally don't happen that, for example, I decide to do ventral or lay graph and I need the change intraoperatively. Don't happen normally, rarely happened. When I decide one technique, I proceed with this technique. Because another important steps is before surgery, any patient had retrograde and avoiding uretrography in my screen. Other way, don't enter in the hospital. Sometime happened. My assistant showed me the X-ray. Ah, dice, professor, this is the X-ray of the patient. Boom, retrograde. And I say, listen, where is voiding? Ah, but go in radiology and perform voiding uretrography and return back here. Of course, because the radiological study of the urethra, ma also in the voiding also, is fundamental steps. Secondary, any patient who underwent uretroplasty, penile, bulbar, perform uretroscopy to check. And we use for uretroscopy 7 French ureteroscope. Very, very long, but not very, very small. And with this 7 French uretrotomy, you can pass also some ring that they are, and you can arrive better where you like arrive. Because sometimes you need to evaluate bulbar urethra stricture disease, and you have some irregular penile urethra, and the instrument 15, 16 don't progress. No. You need to progress with the 7 French ureteroscope, check all the urethra, but not only. In any patient, we need to check the bladder neck, the prostate. Because maybe you can do perform uretroplasty, a patient had the problem for the bladder neck that you have no evaluate preoperatively. This is the complete evaluation of my patient. In my opinion, this render the in my surgery the complication rate really very, very low, very, very low.
Sir, what is the long-term follow-up investigation apart from history? Do you recommend uroflometry or the score voiding score? Which
no,
one?
No. We perform for follow-up. First one, you need to discuss with the patient. Patient come back in the office and sit down and you ask, how is? You are okay? You had infection, you had fever, you had pain, you had burning, your flow is decreasing in the last months. What happened? What happened? First one is the patient that say, doctor, I am okay. Or is the patient that say, doctor, last time, 6 months ago, I was better. Now I feel something that is not okay. At this time you perform a ureflometry. If ureflometry is more than peak flow, 12, no problem. We see after 6 months. If ureflometry is below 12, 10, we need to investigate any patient with uretrography or retroscopy.
Okay.
This is our approach.
What is your suture material of choice? Most of the times, which suture material you prefer?
Bicryl. It's fantastic suture material, Bicryl. I take this in America with George Webster Bicryl many years ago, and this fantastic material.
What is this new glue? What does it contain? Why only in Italy can we use it?
No. It's widespread in any part of the world. The company Sanjay know well. The company is Glubran from Italy. I don't know what is the component, but many years ago we started using another kind of the glue. Not this one, but doesn't work as glue. Probably work as hemostatic, but not like glue. This is very efficient. Also like glue, not only for hemostasis. It's fantastic. We use this glue also for hemostasis. When we close the urethra and there are some bleeding, not important, in the lateral aspect, in the scrotum, we inject some of this glue here that is very efficient hemostatic product.
Sir, what is your
Chandramohan?
Yes, sir.
Chandramohan, Reliance Life Sciences, they produce a glue in India.
Sir.
And it is reasonable expensive. Not too expensive, reasonable cost.
Yes.
Reliance.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, bulbospongiosus muscle sparing perineal approach. A comment.
We do this technique many years ago and we publish in European Urology one or two articles. Was nice, but is a little bit time requiring, is not efficient as we believe. For this reason, now we don't use this muscle sparing technique. No, we don't use.
Not for ventral only, but dorsal only you can.
Yes, for dorsal, okay, but not in ventral. Render working inside the urethra sometimes may be more difficult because the muscles are not opened, but are down, and sometimes you can arrive better in the proximal part. So we suggest, but over time, we perform an incredible number of the surgery each year, like lesser than Sanjay, but more surgery. And anytime we introduce some new steps, but when we introduce a new steps, we check one time, two time, three time. If we realize that the new steps doesn't is not efficient, is not important, we leave many suggestions in our practice that are not important to follow, not important to do, absolutely.
Sir, nowadays TURP is such commonly performed, especially in nucleation procedures, may lead to stricture, a little proximal bulbomembranous region or proximal bulbar. They are very difficult to treat what is your comment? First of all, patient may not be happy for open surgery, we fear the incontinence because bladder neck is disturbed.
Yes.
Your comment on the approach and precautions and the technique.
Thank you. This is very, very, very important question. Because what happened? In Italy, as I believe in many parts of the world, the urologist, you need to consider that the urologist don't know nothing about the urethra. Start with this concept. The general urologist don't know nothing what is the urethra. The general urologist see patient, this happened very, very frequently, that have obstructive symptom. And they say, make investigation, investigate first one, the prostate. Make the you have a prostate, we need to do transurethral resection of the prostate. Listen, patient is admitted in the hospital. I read many, many reports about this. And what happened? The urologist went enter in the urethra to do resection of the prostate, find ring or stricture in the membranous part, near the sphincter. What he do? He do urethrotomy and resection of the prostate. This is terrible. As you explain, because remove the bladder neck and leave the stricture in the membranous sphincter area. This is terrible. We have many, many patients on this condition. Sometimes happened different way. The patient is healthy, had no stricture disease, performed transurethral resection of the prostate, and later develop stricture in the membranous part. What is the treatment? We publish with Sanjay an article, very, very nice, in World Journal of Urology, how to treat this membranous stricture disease in a sphincter area, preserving the continence in patient without functional bladder neck. Is a special ventral array technique I designed that provide us high success rate, not only for the continence, but for the urinary flow, but also for the continence. But when patient can be showing me this membranous urethral stricture disease without bladder neck, the bladder neck is open, I explain, listen, first one, I need to do uretroscopy to check the distance, the true distance between the stricture and the deveromontanum. If 1 centimeter, less than 1 centimeter, or if the stricture involves the deveromontanum. After that, I can decide to do or not to do surgery for risk of incontinence. But normally we can do surgery, but we inform a patient that after surgery, maybe he develop some degree of incontinence that should be not important incontinence or moderate incontinence or severe incontinence. I don't know. I say I do surgery, I do my best to avoid, but maybe that happened. Normally, patient develop some degree of incontinence not important when they remove the catheter 2, 3, 6 months after they are some recovery of the continence. But if they are risk, high risk, the stricture is in the veromontanum, I prefer avoid the urethroplasty.
Okay. My last question, sir. In the dorsal onlay, in the proximal bulbar stricture, if you are going proximal to the bifurcation of the corpora cavernosa, people prefer ventral, but dorsal also can be done will that bed is okay to take quilting in the proximal part of the bulbar urethra by dorsal onlay buccal mucous urethroplasty. I mean to ask, proximal bulbar urethra close to membranous region, what is your take on dorsal if one is well versed with it?
I don't use the dorsal approach, dorsal onlay graft in the very proximal bulbar urethra, because the risk of a problem, bleeding and the impotence is very high. Okay. I approach the proximal bulbar urethra only by ventral approach.
Okay.
Leaving the urethra intact in the junction with the corpora cavernosa. Because okay, entering in this area, you can have impotence. George Webster published one case with the dorsal onlay graft in this part, and the patient was impotent. And George let me know that he have a very, very big legal problem.
So when do you transect the bulbar urethra in your clinic, Guido?
When they are traumatic bulbar urethra stricture disease.
Yeah.
Previous history of trauma, open trauma, and the scarred tissue that close with the wound 1, 2, 3, 4 centimeter gap. Other way, we don't use, we don't transect the urethra. Another suggestion.
And tell us the story of this patient who said, my glans is cold.
Ah, okay. So many.
No, because as a urologist, we never ask this question to a patient. Tell the story, please.
Okay. Many years ago, in any bulbar urethra stricture disease, apart etiology, any etiology, when the stricture was 1-2 centimeter long, I performed bulbar end-to-end anastomosis, as suggested in the literature, of course. But what happened? One day I performed in a very young man, 37 year old, in Rome, I record very, very well, from Rome, bulbar end-to-end anastomosis for 2 centimeter bulbar urethra stricture disease, maybe idiopathic, not traumatic. After six months or before, patient come back to the office for follow-up, show me the uroflowmetry, and the uroflowmetry was 32 peak flow. I say, oh my God, I am happy. The flow is fantastic. You are happy. This man say, doctor, you destroy my life. Sorry, you destroy my life. Sorry. After your surgery, I lost the gland. My gland is becoming swollen and cold. I can have sexual intercourse with my wife. My wife go out. I was divorced for this reason. Oh my God. Oh my God. I ask at my secretary immediately to contact immediately all patients who underwent bulbar end-to-end anastomosis and to complete questionnaire. We publish the result in Journal of Urology. We discover very important incidence of sexual dysfunction after end-to-end anastomosis. The main dysfunction was the gland is cold, the gland is swollen. I lost the sensitivity in the last part of the penis. I lost part of erection in the distal part of the penis. So many, many important thinking. And this suggests me to stop to transect the urethra. You know, we start with Sanjay, with your help, popularizing the non-transecting technique. For this reason, I investigate, was published, you can find in Journal of Urology, end-to-end anastomosis, the results, significant number of cases. My secretary send to the patient this questionnaire, and when I read the results, I remain surprised.
So, Dr. Chandramohan, I just want to tell my friends that all over the world, now yes, we follow Dr. Barbagli's algorithm for managing the bulbar and the penile urethral stricture. I think this is one of the great contributions to urology. that we follow his algorithm about bulbar urethra, transection versus non-transection. In penile urethra, simple versus complex. Simple is treated as one stage, complex is treated by two stage. And most important is that we published a paper together in Indian Journal of Urology for complex penile urethral stricture. We don't insert the graft in stage one. We do Johansson's first stage, that means we open the urethra, leave it open. And in the second stage, we insert the buccal mucosa graft dorsally as an ASOPA dorsal inlay, and then we close. I think this is a very significant contribution of Dr. Barbagli to the urethroplasty world.
Thank you very much, sir, for both of you. We really enjoyed the surgery, very meticulous, and all your experience. Many comments have come from across the world. They are very happy, especially catheter keeping for 1 month, especially knowing about urethra, especially passing a small ureteric catheter always. We feel as endourologists, a guide wire has to be passed in ureter always. There is no reason.
Bye-bye, Sanjay, my friend.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you,
Kulkarni, sir.
Chandramohan, the program was fantastic. Thank you, Dr. Barbagli.
I should thank you, sir, for introducing me and bringing him to this audience. Otherwise, it might have not been possible. Thank you very much, sir. It's a great program, and many, many audience will get benefited with your help to me. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.